we have played the wrong role in not uniting the nation, but in dividing the nation. And that is why, Waihiga, our agenda on the Azimio side is to first unite the country. Because we believe that even if you are to put food on the table, even if you are going to put cash in people's pocket, but there is no cohesion. A Kikuyu and a Kalenjin cannot live side by side. A Luo and a Kisi cannot live side by side. As long as we still look at each other as Kisi, Luya, Arab, and Indian, that food on the table will not satisfy us. That money in the pocket will not be there sustainably. And that is why, in our hierarchy of policies, at the top of it is national unity. After that, we go to economic prosperity. And after that, we go to social justice. Havi said that we should be responding to the things that were said in Eldoret. Waihiga, there is nothing to respond to. 96% of the speakers were chanting Harambee and UDA, and others were calling Raila Amganga, and that script has been there.
You don't have to repeat what they said.
That script has been there. We don't waste time to respond to it. But there's one thing the Deputy President said that I agreed with, surprisingly. The Deputy President said that there is a shortage of fools in this country, and I agree with him absolutely. Hakuna wajinga Kenya hii. Because if Kenyans were fools,
your translation is upside down. Kenya haina upungufu wa wajinga.
There is no shortage. Okay, Kenya haina upungufu wa wajinga.
There's a scarcity of fools in Kenya.
Now let me put it properly. If there was no shortage of fools in Kenya, then we would forget that the Deputy President has been in cabinet from the year 2002 to date. In the Moi government, in the Kibaki government, and as a deputy president in the Uhuru government. All these things is talking about bottom up. Why didn't he espouse them when he was in office? If there was a shortage of fools in Kenya, then we would forget that the deputy president was in charge of agriculture at a time when we had far-reaching reforms in the agriculture sector. If the issues is talking about around fertilizer prices and subsidies and National Cereals and Produce Board, can he give us a scorecard of his performance during that time? If there was a shortage of fools in this country, Waihiga, then we would forget that in terms of dispossession of persons like the late Muteshi, in terms of land grabbing, and in terms of corruption allegations,
I'm talking about a matter that is a fact.
I am not making it up. The issue of Western Hotel is still in the courts of law. Why is it that corruption cases keep swirling around the head of the Deputy President like flies
Senator,
would follow.
Let me ask you this. If there was a shortage of fools in this country,
Waihiga, we would not reflect on those things.
Let me ask you this briefly. How do we handle hate speech challenges moving forward? Politicians will continue scapegoating and saying, it wasn't what I meant, etc. We need solutions. Where do we find solutions?
There is a process that is going on now. Senator Linturi, Senator Cheriot, and Honorable Onyonka are before the criminal justice system for their utterances. Let us allow them to do what they need to do. Moses Kuria has talked of certain sections of the law having been deemed unconstitutional. Those arguments will be presented before the courts of law. The issue of self-regulation by politicians has failed. Our politicians, unless you've got consequences, unless you show them consequences, unless you show them a sword, we've shown ourselves to be incapable of self-regulation. It took the threat of ICC. It took the threat of jail terms for Uhuru Kenyatta and William Ruto for them to be forced to work together to cobble up the Jubilee coalition. Yet, that also did not solve the problems that we had. The NCIC that has been bastardized over its inability to rein in these warmongers and hate mongers. One of the cardinal duties of the NCIC is to define and advocate a national identity and values. And I think there we have failed as a nation. We have failed to come up with a national identity. Mm-hmm. We have failed to come up with values where Kenyans look at themselves as Kenyans the same way Tanzanians look at themselves as Tanzanians.
Okay.
And that is a cardinal point in our Azimio la Umoja. And that's why I said building a nation is at the top of the hierarchy. In fact, you'd rather build a nation first instead of saying that let's make our people rich and build the nation later. We will go the Ethiopia way.
President Havi, even as you respond, we haven't heard much of successful prosecution of cases of hate speech. In fact, the little research that I did, many cases have collapsed in court. And the only case that was successful, I think there's a university student who was jailed for, I think, about a year for advice for abuse on social media. What does that tell us about the threshold of the law on hate speech?
Now, the reason why we have continuously experienced handicaps in successful prosecution of hate speech is because often hate speech has been politicized. It has been weaponized. Why do I say so? I say so because of the following reasons. Hate speech is specifically defined under the Act. And in this particular case, is utterances or action that tend to indicate discrimination on ethnic basis. Ethnicity. That is the fundamental issue. Now, what always happens is this. Whenever a particular person speaks in a way that may be perceived to be influential or divergent, and without proper oversight, investigative bodies kick in. Look at the case of Mithika Linturi, and permit me to repeat it. What did the Director of Public Prosecution say? Commence investigations and give me the file within 14 days. And here is where I agree to a very little extent with Dr. Fred Matiang'i. We have a problem in the police force. I think it's a problem of comprehension. What was difficult in that statement? Was it an order to arrest? No. So you arrest somebody, you unlawfully detain him, and then when you come to court, you have no charge. You have no witnesses. The case is dead on arrival. What should we do? Let's follow what the law says. A complaint must be lodged with the National Cohesion and Integration Commission. It must be interrogated. Conciliation must be pursued. If it fails, then prosecution must ensue. And for you to bring a case that will succeed on prosecution, it must be a genuine case. You see, if I was to go and say, this guy has called me a demagogue, has called me a cultist, those are mere insults. And people with greater learning like myself are impervious to such insults. But some have what we call in law the egg skull susceptibility. They are susceptible. You understand? So the onus here rests on the National Cohesion and Integration Commission as well as the Director of Public Prosecution. The director must stop being impetuous. He must be calm. He must be collected. He must let due process to be followed. Otherwise, you'll go up with a case like this one. Look, what is the fine for this offense? It's 1 million. On what basis will a magistrate give a suspect a cash bail of 2 million? You don't see something wrong?